Hello. So nice to meet you at this daily motivational meeting, reading quotes from world scriptures. This quote empower billions of people and will help you too. We're reading the book from the beginning. Please find all the chapters at our Message to Billions channel. And today's special, we have very interesting topic to read about the religion, the purpose of religion. All religions share a certain purpose in common, though with different emphasis. For Western religions, the primary purpose of religion is salvation. The etymology of the word religion derives from a Latin word meaning to rebind with God. Human beings are fallen and broken, and therefore God has established religion as a means of repairing our brokenness, restoring us to our original goodness, and reconnecting us with God. In contrast, the Eastern understanding of religion is contained in its Chinese characters, which means foundational teaching. This describes the purpose of religion as the basic teaching for cultivation a good and virtuous character. Father Moon recognized both meaning in as much as fallen human being cannot finally cultivate virtuous character without resolving sin and being with God. He distinguished two valid aspects of religion. First, providential religion, Judaism and Christianity, whose purpose is to welcome the Messiah who comes to solve original sin and restore full communion with God. And second, religion, the world over those purpose and mainly to train people in virtue. The kingdom of God is built on both of these foundations. Religion also has a social purpose to cultivate community, and religions teach the ways of love and recognition that enable people to live in peace and harmony. By extension, the ultimate purpose of religion is to establish world peace. That is because God is the creator and father of all humankind. Religions that take us close to God enable us to feel part of the universal brotherhood and sisterhood that flows from his parental love. Religions provide the way of salvation. First quote from the Bible, man, what must I do to be saved? And they said, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household. Another quote, seek refuge with the Lord alone, with you whole being harata. By his grace, you with reach supreme peace and everlasting state. Surely the true religion with God is Islam, the surrender. Those who formally receive the scriptures, if they argue with you, O Muhammad, I say, I have surrendered my purpose to God, and so have those who follow me. And say to those who have received the scriptures and those who have not read them, have you also surrendered? If they surrender, then truly they are rightly guided. To many, a refugee fear-stricken men betake themselves to hills, woods, groves, trees, and shrines. Nay, no such refugee is safe, no such refugee supreme, no by resorting to such a refugee is one freed from ill. He who has gone for refuge to the Buddha, the teacher, the Dharma, the teaching, and the Sangha, the thought, sees with right knowledge the four noble truths, sorrow, the cause of sorrow, the transcendent of sorrow, and the noble eightfold path which lead to the sensation of sorrow. This indeed is refugee secure. By seeking such refuge, one is released from all sorrow. Surely the path that leads to worldly gain is one, and the path that leads to Nibbana is another. Understanding this is he who that is disciple of the Buddha should not rejoice in worldly favors, but cultivate detachment. Father, let's read from quotes from the Second Coming Messiah, Father Sun Myung Moon. Why throughout history have people needed to improve themselves through moral ethics and religion? Why should we observe them? It is because we sense something is wrong with us and we desire to return to original standing before God. However hard the original mind may struggle to attain goodness, we can hardly find any examples of true goodness in this world under the sovereignty of evil. Human beings have thus been compelled to seek the source of goodness in the world transcend of time and space. This necessarily have given birth to religion. Through religion, fallen people, mirrored in ignorance, have sought to meet God by sincerely striving toward the good. Even though the individuals, people, and nations that championed a certain religion may have perished, religion itself survived. God, the parent of humankind, cannot remain aloof when he seeks his sons and daughters in their fallen state. They are like broken radios. So God created repair shop to fix them. And these repair shops are religion. Seeing the many traces of this repair shop down through history, we cannot deny the existence of God. If God used his almighty power, he could easily save all humanity. Then he wouldn't need the religion. But why does God need religion? God wants the enemy to surrender willingly. When that happens, God can become the center and heal all beings. That is God's strategy. Religion does not have humankind as its primary object. Rather, religion teaches establish God, the parent, as foremost. A life of following God's will is a course to establish and mature in the relationship with God. Therefore, holy men and women invariably support the will of heaven and declare the heart of heaven. A true religion should teach people about God. A true religion should not have some vague idea about God. A true religion should be able to give a clear picture of God so that people can understand him. A religion that compromises with the world cannot be called a higher order religion. That kind of religion will ultimately decline. A true religion should teach people the path to know God clearly, to become one with God, and finally to reestablish the world that God originally intended at the creation. After all, the purpose of religion is to seek for the ideal world, a world without sin, a world where all people enjoy the original relationship with God. We know that the main problem here is not which denomination, which religion, or which group we belong to. The viewpoint of truth, the entirety of truth, is to have an inward heart that thou can recognize, and to go forth with an earnest heart that can experience thy heart. O Father, grant us know thy heart. So, powerful quotes for today. If you have difficulties today, please watch one more time this video, share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Subscribe, contact me for consultation, cooperation, and to become a member of this heavenly parents holy community globally. If you want to participate, live at this meeting and receive more grace, write a comment and wish you a great, blessed, happy day. See you tomorrow, same time, same place. All the best. Bye-bye.